It's full throttle, lights out, and we are racing here in Phillip Island. And Martin does make the dream start from pole position. They shoot down towards the Doohan corner. On the inside, though, was Brad Binder. He can't quite get through, though. Bagnaia stays in third place. Marquez running wide through the Doohan corner. But Martin executes the perfect start. He leads for the first time through the Southern Loop. Bagnaia just stands firm, but Martin and Binder here are checking out. Didget does go for it on the inside of Bagnaia into the Southern Loop. The Gianantoni on course for his first MotoGP podium. This is a sensational performance from the man who hasn't got a ride next year. Unrivaled pace at the moment early on for Martin. He's capitalising on that Michelin soft rear tyre. 1:28.823, 3 tenths quicker than Binder on that last lap. Huge credit here to the Gianantonio. Look at the gap he's already immediately put into Bagnaia in third place. On that lap three, the Gianantonio was 7 tenths quicker than Bagnaia, who does not have the early rhythm here at all, does he? The world champion, a bit of a sitting duck as well. He's coming under massive pressure from Zarco and Marquez. That's the battle for fourth place. Zarco blitzes by Mark Marquez's Repsol. He's going to have the inside line for Doohan corner.
Zarco's now on the inside line and he's going to drift wide into side barrier. Mar Marquez is taking every opportunity available on the table at the moment as Zarco now tries to get the inside now as they go to the hayshed side by side. It's advantage Zarco again.
The Gianantonio pulls out the slipstream. They are side by side and Digia powers on through. Fabio, the Gianantonio then slips into second place on the high-speed run to the Doohan corner. It's getting better and better for the Grazzini Ducati man. This has been the ride of his life, hasn't it? Particularly MotoGP from the Gianantonio, second in the Australian Grand Prix.
Who needs Marc Marquez, I can hear you say, with tongue firmly in cheek, as Fabio Gianantonio, the rider giving way for Marc Marquez, takes second place.
This could be very much game on as they're late drama building here in Phillip Island. Jorge Martin lost 0.4 of a second to Digia on that lap 21, the gap down to 2.4 seconds. And Johan Zarco has found a way through on Pekka Bagnaia. What a battle this is then for the final two spots on the podium. It's back in the hands of Binder on the factory KTM. The Gianantonio there now back in third place.
Prima Pramac Ducati might win this Grand Prix. It might not be Martin. Here comes Zarco up the inside of Binder. He stays in third for now, but Zarco is really coming into this. It's 1.2 seconds with two to go.
He's never had a MotoGP victory. He may well never get a better chance than this one. At the moment, though, he's inside that P3. His first podium beckon since the Sachsenring has been a long, long way. Now he's going through on the inside of Binder. He picks up the South African, taking advantage of that. It's Fabio Gianantonio. They're side by side, aren't they? Two abreast. Zarco has it now coming through Siberia. Binder came out the worst of that one. Johan Zarco has waited 120 Grand Prix. He surely has to go for it. He has to make the move. Does he go for it here into the middle corner? He does on the inside. Martin might even miss the podium here.
Bagnaia
could be taking the victory. What an incredible last lap here. High drama in Phillip Island. You could throw a blanket, a tissue over the top five. Out of Siberia we go. Jorge Martin was, what, 8 corners away?
He's going to be
brilliant
off the podium
victory.
Now.
He's not even going to finish on the podium. That soft rear tyre has destroyed itself. Johan Zarco then now comes to the front of this Australian Grand Prix. Here comes Jorge Martin back into fourth place. But Johan Zarco, finally, we can say the Flying Frenchman is a MotoGP winner here in an unbelievable and incredible Australian Grand Prix. What a race. Zarco wins by 2 tenths of a second. Pekka Bagnaia is second. Increases world championship lead. Fabio Gianantonio does take his first ever MotoGP podium.
If you love MotoGP, like and subscribe so you don't miss a video.